Hello everyone, I'm Matt Foster. I'm the new Extension Research Corn, Cotton, and Grain Sorghum Specialist for the state of Louisiana with the LSU AgCenter. I began this role in January of 2021. I'm stationed at the Macon Ridge Research Station in Winnsboro, Louisiana, as well as the Northeast Research Station in St. Joseph, Louisiana. Here we are the last week of June 2021. I want to give a brief update of the corn crop, some pollination concerns I've been hearing from growers and consultants, and you know, what to look forward to as far as, you know, terminating irrigation, when to terminate your irrigation in your corn crop. First off, I want to say the majority of the corn crop throughout the state has pollinated, so we are through pollinating, except for maybe some of those later planted crops that were planted behind floodwaters. First off, I want to talk about this ear that I have in my hand. As you can see, this ear is filled from the base all the way to the tip. This is ideal. This is what you want to see in your cornfield. You know, if you're seeing this, you want to, you know, push that corn to get the most potential out of that corn crop. Switching gears to another ear that is common to see throughout the cornfield, you can see this ear did not fill out all the way to the tip. You see it's filled. The silks actually start growing from the bottom, the base of the ear, and go to the tip. So as you can see, this tip is smooth to the touch. There's no shriveled kernels. So this is likely a pollination issue. Like either the silks covered that up and the pollen could not reach that area, or the corn actually ran out of pollen to pollinate those ovules. This is, you know, as I said, this is common to see this. And it, you know, as you look at this in the field, you know, if you did see some aborted kernels, you would see, you know, kernels that actually did form, but they're actually shriveled. As you can see on this cob, throughout the cob, you can see gaps. You see some pollination issues right there, as well as a few shriveled kernels throughout the ear. And as you look at this, and you know, as you're estimating your yield potential, you can see this throughout the field, you know, indicating a pollination issue or an abortion issue. So switching gears, I want to talk about staging this corn as far as growth stages. So R1 is going to be your silking stage, up to R2 is going to be your blister stage. R3 is what we like to call the milking stage, or the roasting ear stage. And how you determine that is you can, you know, cut open some of the kernels or pierce some of the kernels, and a white milky substance will be present in the kernels. However, if a gelatinous material is present, that has moved to the R4 stage, the dough stage. And you can see as you move on, you know, throughout the season, when you approach the R5 stage, you can, you know, break that cob in half. You can see a faint milk line at the top of the kernels starting to move down. And at this point in time, we're approximately 20 days, give or take, away from black layer. And what black layer is R6, which is physiological maturity of that corn. And for those farmers that irrigate, this is when you need to determine when to terminate your irrigation based on growth stage and based on moisture in the field. So when you're looking for black layer, you will look at, you know, split the cob open, and you will look at the abscission layer at the bottom. And when that area turns black, that's at the tip of the kernel, when that area turns black, that means that kernel is no longer taking up any moisture or nutrients, and it has reached physiological maturity and irrigation can be terminated. Overall, the corn crop throughout the state looks good. There's been a few isolated areas with some pollination issues that I've been out to, but as we all know, we had a difficult spring, a difficult planting, cool weather. And you know, it's just been a difficult year as far as getting the crop in the ground. I'm responsible for conducting corn, cotton, and grain sorghum trials throughout the state. And I would like to thank the Louisiana Soybean and Grain Research and Promotion Board, as well as Cotton Incorporated, for funding my program, and as well as agents and growers that have graciously cooperated with me as far as putting in on-farm demonstrations throughout the state for corn, cotton, and grain sorghum. I currently have 15 corn demonstrations throughout the state, around 7 cotton, and around, I would say, 4 grain sorghum demonstrations throughout the state. And without that collaboration, I wouldn't be able to do my job. I really am thankful for that. I'd like to thank my research associates, student workers, for all their help and support. And please reach out to your extension agent or myself if you have any concerns in the future as far as your corn crop grows. Thanks.